Texas Congressman Mike Burgess is with us. Congressman, I'm not sure I like the sound of this. I can understand voting remotely in emergency situations, but making this a full-time permanent thing, I can't get into that. How about you?
Oh, no, sir. And bad enough in the current situation where actually that power was given over to the sergeant-at-arms and the House physician, completely unelected positions and arguably administrative positions. But now they're talking about putting it into the basic House rules. Not a good idea. And as it stands, I don't know if people realize this, but 20 Democrats can show up and pass anything that they want to pass, because 218 votes is what takes the day in the House of Representatives. One individual can carry the proxies of 20 other people. So as you can do the math quickly, you're not going to have many people show up in the chamber to push whatever you want to push. And here's the thing. Sometimes a bill is amended. Sometimes things are changed on the floor. And so that person who's given up their proxy to someone, how do they make sure that now their wishes or their district's wishes are adequately reflected in this proxy vote? It becomes an impossibility. This is a representative republic. This is not what we're supposed to do. Other people have to show up for work. We should too, or don't run for the job.
Apart from which, political policy is made by the interaction of people at the water cooler, or passing each other in the corridor, or having a drink at night, or something like that. It's personal conflict is how you, not conflict, contact is how you get through things. But let me move on, because I got a lot to cover here. Secretary Azar, Health and Human Services, on this network this morning, weighed in on new COVID restrictions. He doesn't want a second lockdown. Watch this, please.
You don't need lockdowns, Maria. The data clearly demonstrate the interventions we need are simple, they're demonstrated, they're proven, but they're not forcing people to stay in their homes, shutting down our businesses, shutting our schools.
Congressman, I'm referring this to you because you are a doctor, you're a Republican in Texas, and Texas has a million cases of the virus. Do you agree with Secretary Azar you don't want a second lockdown?
Yeah, I don't think it does any good, and ultimately we're getting some data that it perhaps is more harmful for some situations. But here's the deal. Everyone understands the things that they can do to protect themselves. They haven't really changed. They're not dramatic. Yes, wear a mask, wear a mask that adequately covers your nose and your mouth when you go out. Wash your hands more times than you think it is necessary, and do your best to stay 6 feet away from anybody else unless it's just absolutely necessary. So utilizing those simple things, I think is much better than a lockdown, which just prevents all commerce from happening. But here's the other thing, and you were just talking to my good friend, Dr. Siegel. I mean, this vaccine is a game changer. I don't think people understand that Dr. Fauci told us in a briefing in Congress at the end of January that it would be 18 months before a vaccine could be available if everything goes right, if there's no complications. But here we are, 10 months later, and surprise, surprise, a week after Election Day, we've got not one but two, and two therapeutics. This is remarkable, a remarkable advance in the treatment of this disease. I've never seen anything like it before, and we actually ought to be rejoicing because of the availability of this vaccine, which Dr. Siegel just alluded to, maybe for high-risk populations the end of the month or the end of the year, for the rest of us, mid-spring.
And forget about canceling Thanksgiving. Congressman, thanks very much for joining us. We appreciate your expertise. Good stuff. Thank you, sir.